Shalom, Talmidim, is my favorite time before Shabbat. It's a time for a rega be'ivrit, when you take what you learn in Hebrew 101 and Hebrew 102, and you apply it to the Word of God. This Shabbat, in Parashat HaShavua, in the weekly portion, Parashat Bo, we read an interesting passage in Leviticus chapter 12, where God speaks about the last plague that he will bring upon Egypt. I want you to listen to Exodus 12:23, when it says, Ve'avar Adonai lingof et Mitzrayim, okay, for the Lord is going through to smite the Egyptian, Ve'ra'a et Adam al Amashkof, and he saw the blood on the doorpost, and he passed over. The word in Hebrew, Pesach, it's come from the word Pasach, to pass over. Ela Petach. But then there is something else. It says, Velo yiten amashchit lavo el batehem lingof, which translated to, and the Lord will pass over the door and not let the destroyer enter and smite their home. The Hebrew word for destroyer is the word mashchit. Why this is insignificant? Who is the mashchit who go and execute judgment? You might think the mashchit is some angel, but the mashchit is the word mem shin chet yu taf. Is the word mashchit derived from the root letter mashach or mashiach. The one who execute God's judgment is none other than the mashiach, who is called the destroyer. But the destroyer here is the messiah himself. Interestingly, in rabbinic literature, the messiah called the mashchit Amim. The word Amim means nations. Mashchit means destroyer. The destroyer of the nations. What is he doing? What he will do in the future? He will destroy the nations. What is he doing in the Torah portion? He destroy Egypt. The word Mashchit comes from the word Mashach, that comes from the Hebrew word Mashiach. Guys, we must remember that the Messiah is not just a tiny lamp, but he is also going to come as a great destroyer and destroy those who do not belong to Hashem in these last days. That's why in the book of Malachi, it is called the great and terrible day. You know the word there in Hebrew, Nora, Gadol and Nora. Nora means terrible. How can this be great and terrible? It will be great for the Israel, because he will redeem Israel. The word there is Gadol, but it also will be Nora, which means terrible, for those who side themselves with Egypt. We must to trust in the fact that he is a mashchit, but he actually look through the power of the blood to redeem us. And that is the rega be'ivrit for us today. We must take upon ourselves and make sure that the blood is upon the doorpost of our homes, so the mashchit will pass over and bring blessings to us. Leitraot.